Okay. It's another guitar day. Got some stuff to work on. American Stratocaster. We got this thing. What is it? A Sanox. That's sort of got a funny story to it. I don't, what the hell is this tape shit on here? A lot of dirt and shit. What's wrong here? What's wrong with this picture? We don't know. It's just got like tape on it. But they put these tuners on it, but they didn't put them on the right sides, so they're all backwards. what else we got over here? A Mann. Oh, man. Another Japanese marvel. Got a few loose controls and stuff, and put some new strings on it. I don't know. How smushed are the frets? Some goof was giving me a hard time about the frets are dented. Of course they're dented. They're not worn. The material didn't disappear. Metal didn't shave off. I hate to break the news to you. The metal's been displaced and moved and squashed, hence dented. Like the fucking guy's head who made the comment. Oh, I'm getting really old and nasty. I better stop. Anyway, let's go with tripod, and then we can do some fun stuff with that today. Got my camera back. My big wide ass son of a bitch wide angle. So what happened? What went wrong here? All these gizmos were loose. All his screws there that hold the knobs in. See, this tripod blows. I gotta change this. Okay, so all these little nuts were loose, and I still gotta put a proper wrench on them. So we'll do that. So, put a little screwdriver in there. And I use the little the crescent wrench. You put a deep socket on there, whatever you want to do. Give those a snug up. Because that's what we do. And of course, you can do this yourself at home. And you can screw it up, but the reason I'm putting the screwdriver in there is to sort of keep the control from spinning around, because that's what breaks the wires off. Oh yeah, that one's sloppy as hell. Fun. So we discover, dirty controls. Maybe not. Maybe it was just, it was the first time they've been turned because they've been so loose. We're gonna blow some juice through all this. Okay, folks have asked, what do you use to clean the controls, Dave? Electrical contact cleaner, automotive department of your favorite store. I get mine from Newfie Speed and Sport. Son of a sea cook. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Let's give those a. They're really good and stiff. Except for that one. That's my little patented gizmo there. that goes over top the control and blows stuff down in the around the shaft and in through the insides. Squeaky as hell. They're really bad. I'll use some that release all stuff and blow some crap in the switch here. Don't lose your straw. We seem to be okie dokie, Gumby pokey. Next is that age-old question. Does the stupid truss rod work? So, what do I got? Oh, I got this little guy. This is a fun little tool. I don't know. They might give you that sometime with a Gibson guitar. I think maybe that's where it comes from. I could be wrong. It's a nice little thing to have. Handy if you're buying a guitar. This is like, you know, this is a super important question if you're going to buy a used guitar. Does the frickin' truss rod work? I mean, even if you know the neck looks straight and stuff. Okay, it's not that type. It's a hex key. Okay, stand by. Yeah, so it works. The truss rod actually functions, and the neck is pretty straight. It's got some fret wear. I'm going to buzz over that a little bit with the fret file. Nothing drastic. Polish things up a little bit. Let's see, what else do I hate about it? The pickup height is incorrect. They need to come down a little bit. Check the intonation. That old gag. And we'll find Buddy a knob. I think they have one at the store for him. And put these guys back on. And yeah. So we'll string it up. We'll string up the Oh Man. Oh Man. I wanted to get right in there and show everybody like how minuscule amount of material is coming off the tops of those. It's microns, and everything's going to be wonderful. Somebody's going, oh, well, that fret there is going to buzz now. You see, I didn't take anything off the top. If you look really close, you can still see the dents are still, some of the dents are still there. But the material's malleable, and the string pushes down and squishes the fret. The unless you're doing sandpaper finger bends on those frets, you're just reorienting the soft wire. And I guess just to talk a little more about that, the dents look a lot worse than they are, because the way the material's smushed out either side. But I mean, I'm going to collect that and show you. I'll collect it on a page and show you how little material comes off there. Okay. This is supposed to be Camille's job. I'm not supposed to be doing this shit anymore. I mean, this highly technical work. Yeah, baby. My stomach's telling me it's time to cook food. Much nicer. Let's polish all of them now, and then we'll oil the fretboard and pop the strings on it. I still got to get Buddy a knob, but they got that at the store, I'm told. Okay. Man up. Made in Japan. Japan.
See, there's the nozzle. We're going to shoot air into there and dry it out, and also clean out, or blow out all the grit and crap that gets stuck in there.
Oh, look, another sticker. Maybe I'll stick it right on the guitar. What do you think? Sound like a plan? This is what they gave me. Not my choice. Once again, going with a little lighter fluid on the cloth, the clean cloth. You know, don't use a rag that's got shit on it already, because then you're just spreading shit around. And this is actually a really, really clean guitar. Hot damn. Just a few drops of the linseed oil. Oh, I need a paper towel. Son of a bitch. Where'd those go? Don't tell me I'm out. Damn it. That looks just freaking nice. He's got a big dirt in the front. Too bad. It's a pretty minty looking machine otherwise. A little bits of stuff on it there. But otherwise, yeah. Well taken care of. Batteries are dead on my co-winder. So I'm using this little snark. This is a different one than I had. That one's got a mic, microphone. Cool. So I watched, I think it was one of those
Expert Village videos where a guy was talking about how to install strings and how to do the knot here and, you know, do that whole thing. And I don't promote that. It's never been proven that the guitar stays in tune any better, because if the tuning peg itself slips, a knot here is not going to save it, because this turns, this slips, the tuner slips. The other thing is it puts a great bit of kink here, and usually the string will break right at that point. The other problem is if you want to get the strings off quick and you're doing a gig, or it's an ass pain because it's knotted itself in there, and it's just makes it more difficult. And as I said, no proof whatsoever that knotting the string here keeps the guitar in tune any better. Another thing that I always like to check on these old babies is the make sure the neck screws are tight, right? It's like, don't want that flopping around. Okay, so that's the man. I gotta put his little cover back on. And like I said, we're gonna get him one of these at the store. Okay, I guess I'll try a little demo. So I got a little different tuning thing going on for the... If you guys are nice to me, I'll tell you what that tuning is someday. Guitar. The thing about these Japanese guitars is that the necks seem to be really skinny and the string spacing really tiny, so that tiny little hands could play it. My fingers barely fit between the strings. And a bunch of cowboys riding the Jesse James. Okay, I better quit. Cheers, folks. It's a man, a Japan man. Pretty cool stuff. Maybe I can dig up some research or something. We'll see what I can find.